Amen. Amen. We're back for part two of Healing Our Lands Church of the Men at Albert Brook. That was Boston's own Rashad McPherson and Divine Purpose songs entitled Overflow. Amen. Thank you for being with us. This broadcast is sponsored by Caleb International Ministry and the Ezra Institute of Apologetics. We're going to go to some more praise and some more worship by more Boston's own. This is Phil Thompson from Jubilee Christian Church, and the song's entitled Atmosphere Shift.
We worship the Lord. Come on, help me say, there is only one name. Come on, sing it out.
There is only one name with power to save.
Hey.
Power to save.
We'll sing it out again. There is only one name.
There is only one name.
Come on, lift up your voices.
There is only one name.
Power to save.
Power to save.
Power to save.
Power to save. In our God, champion, he reigns forevermore.
Boston's own, amen, Phil Thompson songs entitled Atmosphere Shift. Amen. You're tuned in to Healing Our Lands Church of the Midnight Hour, broadcast sponsored by Caleb International Ministry and the Ezra Institute of Apologetics. Amen. We're going to go to some more music by Jubilee Church, and this song is entitled No Bondage.
No other name but the name of Jesus. There's no prayer that cannot pay the grace you freely give. It's the raging flood
that covers us.
For the thoughts that come to decay,
you've sent love to strip them
away,
and you've left the truth
that we're free in you.
There is no bondage, every chain is broken. There is no bondage. Jesus, our hearts are open. No guilt, no shame. All my sins in grace. There is no bondage. Every chain is broken.
There's no hope.
There's no hope.
I cannot live. Say the grace.
The grace. Freely. It's the raging blood
that covers us.
That covers us.
Yes, if for the thoughts.
For the thoughts that come to decay.
Come on, so you sent love.
You sent love
to strip them away.
Strip them away. And you left the truth
that we're free in you. If you believe that in this place, I dare you to just shout it out. See, there is no bond.
There is no bondage.
See, every chain is
broken. Every chain is broken.
There is no bondage.
There is no bondage.
See, Jesus, our hearts are open.
Jesus, our hearts are open.
See, there is no guilt.
No guilt.
No shame.
place. Open your mouth and worship.
Good morning, my brother Michael Penn. Thank you for being with me. Bless your celebrity to life.
Oh God,
more of Jubilee worship coming to you. Songs on top of the Lord's Prayer.
Yeah.
Jubilee Worship coming to you. Actually, this is Ashmont Hill out of Jubilee Worship. Song entitled Sanctuary. Good morning. Well, bless you, my dear friend. Oz friend tuning in from Australia.
Walls, I see the beauty of your spirit fall. You come and cover me. Depths of you, I'm not afraid. You're what I'm holding to. You're here, you shelter me.
Sanctuary is the name of the song, Boston's own Ashmont Hill. Amen. Feeling led to go share with you at this time something entitled Worship, Revealing Who He Is, Exhortation. And again, I want to acknowledge my friend and my sister in the person of Brenda Pelletier, who blessed me with this and then blessed my life. And I want to bless you with it as well. Intimate exchange of identity.
Thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your kindness. Thank you for your power. Thank you for your love that you have blessed us with. The love that you set before the foundations of the world. Thank you, Holy Spirit, because even while you began the work of creation, in the time you began to draw the blueprint, in the time you began to decide where the mountains should be, and you decided where the river should flow from, you decided where you were going to locate every waterfall and where the springs were going to be, even from that moment, God, you decided in your heart how you were going to bless us. It is all about your love for us. It is all about your goodness. It is all about your kindness. This has nothing to do with anything that we have done. This has nothing to do with anything that we have achieved. This has nothing to do with anything that we have given to you. This is a love, oh God, that was preordained. This is a love story that was written before it was written. This is a love story that began and ended even before it was ever told. This is a love story that you formed in your heart. You went into the secret place, you that is the secret place. You went into the secret place place of your being. You went into the secret place of your heart. You went into the secret place of your soul. You did not take counsel with any man, oh God, when you were going to decide to love us. You did not ask anybody what it was going to look like or what the love story should feel like. You did not take counsel, oh God, with the angels in heaven when you decided what our inheritance should be. You, oh God, you went into yourself and you searched for all the goodness. You searched for all the power. You searched for all the glory. You looked for everything that was beautiful. And that's why you said you have blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places. Every single thing that could be called a blessing. Every single thing that could be called good in your presence. You gathered it together. You gathered it together. You did not leave a single goodness. You did not leave a single blessing. You did not leave a single thing that is called precious, oh God. And you put it all together like a father that went on vacation and gathered good gifts for his child. You endlessly, oh God, are longing for the day that you will shower upon us and you will do the great reveal of all the beautiful things that you have laid ahead of us. Oh Father, who can compare to you? Who can talk about your greatness? For your greatness is not just in the fact that you have a throne that is higher than every other throne, but your greatness is in the fact that you are willing, oh God, to share your glory with many others. To share your glory not with people who are deserving of it, but to share your glory with people who have no idea what you have given to them. Who is like unto you, God? Who can compare to you? Who has been able to create a love that is as great as your love? Who can speak, oh God, of your power and your majesty? For nobody even understands what your power and your majesty is like, because your majesty is hidden, oh God, even in this earthen vessel, oh God, this weak clay vessel, Jesus, that nobody will take a second look at. When we walk through the universe, nobody will look at us because our bodies are weaker than the bodies, oh God, of the angels and the hosts of heaven that does not decay. Yet you have chosen that in this weak vessel, Jehovah, you are going to have the treasure of all eternity. For inside of us, oh God, we bear a witness that what we carry inside of us is eternal and is holy. For somewhere in my heart, Jesus, even though my body be weak, yet in my soul I know that I carry a fire that cannot quench for all eternity. Oh, Maruma, 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 invest so much in people that can so not be depended on. It's still a mystery, God. Even the wise kings of the universe, they still sit and they wonder between themselves, how is it that the great I am can invest so much in people who can carry so little? It's still a mystery, God. For perhaps, Jesus, in our worship, we unravel the mystery that you have hidden from all creation. For perhaps in the times that we take our faces away from who we are and we turn our eyes towards who you are, then we are able to discover the things that who you are has hidden in who we are, Lord. For perhaps this is the mystery of our worship. That is not about an egocentric God that wants people to keep talking about how powerful he is. But it's about a God who is loving. It's about a Father who is so true. And he has something so great for his children that he has hidden it as a secret within them. And every time they worship him, every time they turn to him, every time they fix their gaze on him, in their eyes they see a picture of who they truly are. In their eyes they see a burning fire that represents what he has placed within them. As they turn their faces towards him, and as it shines brighter and brighter in the brightness of his light, somehow there is a fall of his picture and his image upon them, and there is a sudden realization of who they are. Perhaps this is what our worship is about, not just the fact that we fall in fear that if we don't give you the praise it will kill us. No, but this is the fact that as we worship you, oh God, you show your love towards us because you begin to show us who we are in you. Jesus, such an intimate exchange of identity, such an intimate exchange of power, such an intimate glory, oh God, that I step into your presence and I bring in worship my weakness and my brokenness, and I drag before me, oh God, all that I am not. And somehow in the midst of it, great God, great King, who is feared by all, the one whose name cannot be mentioned in the courts of heaven, the one whose presence no one dares to approach, but somehow as broken as I am, when I come before you in worship, Jesus, you pull back the darkness that covers your throne and you say, here I am. And as I take a look at my Father, I realize I'm not so broken, I'm not so weak, I'm not so small. If this is my Father, then there must be something within me that looks like him. For a lion gives birth to a lion. Fire gives birth to fire. The light gives birth to light. This is worship, the intimate exchange of identity. Landele barukahai. Shivandele debronde kinahai. Vreskute flenihai. Jesus.
Boston's own Andre Lang. All that I am is created to worship.
I lived a life. Worship to you.
Hallelujah.
The one my door. You are my light, strength and my joy. Lord, I worship you with all. All of the earth, can no one do what you do? You're God all by yourself. You're righteous and you're holy. In all of your ways, When I think of what you've done, the only thing left to do is praise. Lord, you're so awesome, and your greatness is unsearchable. When I think of how much you love me, sometimes it's unbelievable. But I lift up my hands.
Yes,
I lift up my hands.
Yes, yes, Father. Yes.
In worship to you.
Yes, God.
The one who I adore.
You are my strength and my joy.
Lord, I worship you with all that I am.
Yes, God, all that I am, I worship you, Father. Yes, God.
Yes, Jesus. For there is none like you in all of the earth. Can no one do what you do? You're God all by yourself.
Yes, Jesus.
You're righteous and you're holy in all of your ways. When I think of what you've done, the only thing left to do is praise. Lord, you're so awesome, and your greatness is unsearchable, yeah. When I think of how much you love me,
yes, God.
Sometimes it's unbelievable, but I lift up my hands.
Yes,
I lift up my eyes in worship to you, the one whom I adore. You are my strength and my joy. Oh, Lord, I worship you with all that I am. With all that I am. Father, I worship you with all that I am, with all that I am. Father, I worship you, oh yeah, with all that I am, yeah. All that I am,
yes, God.
All that I am. With all that I am.
Yes, God, all.
With all that I am.
Yes, God,
all that I am. Oh, Lord. All that I am. All that I am. I worship you, yeah. With all that I am.
And all that I am, Boston's own Andre Lang is the artist. That's the title cut of the project. All that I am is created to worship you, Father God. Yes, to your will. Yes, to your way.
With all that I am.
Yes, God.
All that I am.
More music coming in by Andre Lang. Songs entitled Take Me Higher.
Take me higher.
Deeper depths.
Yeah.
Higher heights.
Higher, yes, Lord. in thee. Take me high, yeah. That's where I long to be. High, yeah. To a greater place in thee. Lord, I'm thankful for where you brought me from. Higher.
God, yes, God, yes, God. Higher, Lord, in you. Take me. Yes, Father, take us higher. Yes, Lord. Be glorified in and through us, your people. Higher.
To a greater
place in thee.
Lord, I'm thankful.
Lord, I'm thankful for where you brought me from.
Lord,
take me. That's where I want to be.
Oh, higher. Lord, I'm thankful.
Lord, I'm thankful for where you brought me from. Take me higher.
Thank you, Jesus. Oh, take me.
Take us higher, Lord.
Higher. Oh,
that's where I want to be.
Take me
higher.
To a greater place.
To a greater place.
Lord, I'm thankful.
Lord, I'm thankful for
where you brought me from. Father, I worship you.
Yes, God.
And I give you the praise. In a great place is where I long to be. For everything that you do, Lord, I say thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, and Father, we give,
yes,
you,
God, we give you all the
praise.
God, we give you the honor. We're grateful, Father. Yes, God. Good morning, my brother Warren Ellenberg.
And you're greatly to be praised.
Yes, God. Blessings to you and yours.
Oh, thank you, Lord. And we bow down and we worship you.
We worship you. We worship you.
Just because of who you are, Father, we worship you.
Yeah. We worship you.
Hey, oh yeah. Lord, I'm thankful for when you brought me from. Take me higher. Higher. Lord, I'm thankful for where you brought me from, and I'm grateful that I'm not where I used to be, but I know there's a greater place, a greater anointing, there's a greater power, there's a greater relationship, there's a greater worship. I want more of you.
Boston's own Andre Lang, songs entitled Take Me Amen, amen. My mercy coming to you by Rally Worship. And this song is entitled The Father's Love. Bear with me here. A little technical challenge. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
The Father's love is indescribable. The Father's love is unexplainable. The Father's love is unbelievable. The Father's love, it is available.
It is available. Nothing can separate us from the love of God. Full of mercy, full of grace for the undeserving ones. Nothing can separate us from the love of God. Full of mercy, full of grace for the undeserving ones. Oh. The Father's love, it is incredible. The Father's unconditional. The Father's love, it is unstoppable. The Father's love, it is available. It is available. Undeserving ones. Nothing can separate us from the love of God. Full of mercy, full of grace for the undeserving ones. The undeserving ones. Death nor life, and there's no depth and there's no height that will ever separate us from the love of Jesus. No powers and no rulers, there's nothing present and there's nothing future that will ever separate us from the love of Jesus. So give up that heart of stone and let the Father love you. The Father loves you. Oh, give up that heart of stone and let the Father love you. The Father loves you. This is the moment, this is the day. Give up that heart of stone, let His love wash
love wash you away. Nothing can separate us from the love of God. Full of mercy, full of grace for the undeserving ones. Nothing can separate us from the love of God. Full of mercy, full of grace for the undeserving ones.
Hallelujah, the Father's love. My time just about come to an end, beloved family. Thank you for being with me. I'm going to play a little piece of Rest My Soul as we sign off and prepare for the next broadcast. Love you to life. God loves you as well. I never want to close out a broadcast without giving you an opportunity to invite Jesus Christ into your life as your Lord and Savior. Jesus said, I'm the way, I'm the truth, and I'm the life. No one comes to God the Father but through relationship with Jesus the Christ. We must believe that God is Jesus and that He died and He rose again. And we must invite Him into our life as our Savior and our Lord. John 3:16, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him would not perish but have eternal life. Won't you invite Him into your life by saying this prayer of invitation? Lord Jesus, I know I'm a sinner. I believe that You died for my sin. And right now I turn from my sin. I open the door of my heart and my life. I receive You, Jesus the Christ, as my Savior and my Lord. Thank You for forgiving me and giving me eternal life with You and abundant life in this life. Hallelujah. The angels in heaven are rejoicing over one soul that's invited Christ into your life. Seek the Holy Spirit to lead you to a biblical community where you can heal, mature, and walk in holiness. We'd love to support you in that endeavor. Give us a call at 617-282-0685, 617-282-0685, or write us at 670 Washington Street, Dorchester, Mass. 02124, care Pastor Hobbs. We love You to life. God loves you as well. Be blessed. Thank You for Your presence.
Your presence, Jesus. Yeah.